Hello and happy final day of 2020. My name is Olivia for anyone who's new. In today's video, I am going to be wrapping a few of the wraps that I've been wrapping over the past couple of days that I have not had a chance to make videos for, or like the scarf of the month here. The one wrap I went through really quick during the video and didn't really use my words and explain what I was doing. So I'm going to be showing this one too. Now for the first wrap, I'm going to do the winter, excuse me, the winter enchantment wrap, and that one was done with this lavender Shinylicious and the blue, this blue Lakeshore Bliss. Now you can tell I left them all together here. And the July scarf of the month, which is this guy right here. And it's upside down, sorry. But that was the July scarf of the month. Now, I just slapped this on. I'll just get started really quick because I'm also going to talk about the excuse me, some fun discoveries I made. Oh my goodness, I'm sorry, I forgot my allergy pill. I have some fun discoveries that I made in the Ulta sale last week. Last week. Oh my goodness. Okay. So I have no makeup on right now because I just didn't feel like doing it this minute. I have so many chores to do in the house before tonight. I've decided, I shouldn't say I've decided, we've decided to actually enjoy the bringing in the new year this year instead of just barely making it until midnight and then still falling asleep, you know, like 2 minutes past midnight. This year we're doing fondue, which in our house is fondue. We're gonna do a few courses of fondue, cheesy fondue, and then we're gonna have an entree fondue and then chocolate. So I'm really excited for that. Thanking my sweet daughter for the idea. I was just not knowing what to make for dinner tonight. So it'll be a nice celebration. And we're having Daniele. And it's gonna be nice. It's Alyssa and her friend Daniele, who is like the daughter that is not of my body. I don't know how to put it. It's by my one of my daughters by choice. Alyssa and Danielle have been friends forever. I'm thinking since at least second grade, and they're both in their third year of college, so a really long time. Okay, now, so that I don't talk and not tell you what I'm doing, I'm just this part of the wrap is just like the Leucothea wrap. It's the hair part, so I'm tying it on at an angle. This time I'm going for even-ish. Even-ish tails. Doesn't really matter. I just need to have enough to tuck this side up instead of leaving the ponytail. So I'm trying to get the tail on this side to come out the top of the knot. And when I do that, sometimes I can't talk. Okay. So that one on the top, this one on the bottom. It just makes for a nicer transition to this swoop up in the front. I'm gonna try to get this to give me hair like gathers. This one doesn't gather as well as the original two-in-one or even the tough two-in-one, but it's pretty enough with all the glitters. So I'm gonna fold in the edge a little bit. Me see if I can switch this around so that the flatter end is in the front. That'll be more helpful. Okay. I apologize if you can hear that big truck that's going up the street. Ugh. All right. But it's the UPS men doing their jobs. Okay, so I'm just bringing it around, bringing it up and around, giving it a little bit of texture in the front if I can. This pleats better than it crinkles, if that makes any sense. So I'm trying to find the pocket back here. I'm gonna stuff this up. Okay, now I'm going to take this tail. In the Leucothea wrap, this would stay down and I'd have a ponytail. But I don't really want to have the extra. It's an option if you really want to have the extra tail down. It just changes it to a different wrap. Okay, here's this one, tucking best I can. It doesn't have to be super duper neat because we're covering it up with two other scarves. I just don't want to have the big bump right here. All right, so we have the hair and going on to the blue. Now, when I put this on my head, I'm gonna try to fold this scarf to fit my head really good. And when I do this, the color is gonna go in and out a little bit. The contrast between my, this is why I don't like to make videos with no makeup on because my skin kind of glows, it's weird. And the color kind of goes in and out. Oh my goodness. So I'm going to bring this around and I'm going to have it one really, really long tail, one really short tail, and I'm laying it on my head. I want to have a substantial amount of the hair showing. It's your choice though, if you want it further forward, if you want it further back, totally up to you. But I think this works really well because I get to cover up this portion here. Okay, now this I'm going to crinkle up. I'm going to take this piece and bringing it around the back. I'm not spinning because it's easier for you to see from the front what I'm doing. I'm bringing this up like so. I'm going to lift to show you. I'm going to bring this down and the tension will hold that in. Now, if you see the fringes, just swoop around. You tuck those fringes in if you have any extras running around. This technique takes a little bit of practice, but I use it a lot when I use it a lot so that I know it's muscle memory. I'm trying to get my words out here. I'm so sorry. It's muscle memory and practicing it will make it a lot easier. All right, I'm just gonna fold in the edges here just to make it sort of roundish and leave it drop. Okay, this guy here, you can do this several different ways. I just wanna make a sash of this. You can crinkle it up, you can make folds. So, see if I can do it in air. Like this, you can make the folds to pleat it, like so, all the way down. I'm just crinkling it. And I'm going to turn it around and do that again because I want the buildings in the front because I want that extra bit of color, the different color and texture in the front here so that it's not all blue. Okay, so I'm gathering this up just like so, crinkle, crinkle. When I place it on my head, I'm going to place it on my head the same way I did this one with the very short tail and the very long tail. And I want to make sure that the very long tail comes out on the same side as the blue. So I'm going to place it on my head like so. You have the little tiny tail. I'm going to make this one as tiny as possible because the scarf is a bit shorter than the blue one. Than Lakeshore Bliss. So I'm just bringing it around. Here it is, little tail right there. I'm going to use the same method, just bringing this around, not pulling too tightly. I do not want to squish my head. And then I have the tension holding these in place. Now you see this is a little bulky. I'm just going to pull it around. It was a little bubble. Okay, now when I get to here, I'm going to twist forward, move back. Twist forward, move back. twist forward, move back. Now, if doing it the opposite way, if twisting it backwards and then moving the scarves forward works best for you, you can do it that way. As long as the scarves are being twisted in opposite directions to make a rope braid or a rope twist. So I'm twisting forward, moving back, twisting forward, moving back, all the way down. And it's a little tedious, but get beautiful results. Okay, so I'm going to now tuck that guy back in. Okay, all right, I'm gonna bring this up. Now the placement of this is up to you. You can have it further forward, you can have it further back. I just try to have it somewhere in the middle. And I'm keeping some tension on it so that it doesn't go rolling all over the place. I'm gonna sit properly in the chair. Now, when I bring it around, there's gonna be a little bit of weirdness right here that I'm smoothing down. And I'm bringing this over. Now what I did was I brought this up and I tucked it in as best I could into the twist. Okay. Now I know there's some fringes up there, but that's what I did. I can pull on it a little bit to try to make it more balanced, make it more even. And that was the winter enchantment wrap. Again, I'm just fussing with this to make sure that it's nice and neat and you're not seeing those fringe bits on either side. Okay, just like so. Now, if you wanted to have a tail here, what you can do instead of tucking those up is reach through and pull the tails through, just like so. I do like it in this order because this is not really much of a tail, but it gives the body to this one. So spin around, show you the back, like so. Again, this is a little bit messy back here, but we're going out and wearing it. I would definitely make sure it's uber neat and because I'm in the bathroom, I have mirrors facing one another, so I can do that and make sure it's nice and smooth and make sure the bulk is in the proper places. So, okay. All right. Let me take this one off and I'm going to move to the next one. Okay. My friend here. I didn't mention it, but you could also do this wrap, this part of the wrap with no knots if you wanted to eliminate the knots. That would be really easy, just crisscross. Okay. Now, yesterday's wrap, I wore a cute yellow sweater. Oh my goodness, I found the sweater at the Target and I was super excited. I went in to buy a dress and it was one of the dresses that friends had posted, kind of poking fun at the way Target is doing snooze clothing. And I was like, oh, it's cute though. It's cute. It could totally style that to make it adorable and have it be higher end fashion. You know, it was really cute. So I said, oh, I'll just go run to the Target in Pikesville and I'll get it. No problem. Well, I walked in and I had it in my hands and I was like, I would wear it once. I would wear it once just to say hey. And then I said, I don't know. And I held it in my hands and I was walking around trying to figure out what I was going to do. If I was going to buy this piece just to say, this is the way to style this. Or not. When I discovered the yellow sweater with the little flower embroidery, and I was like, oh my gosh, now I can't buy this dress because this is what I want to wear. This is the cute dress. Cute dress. This is a cute sweater that I would wear a lot. So versus once, maybe twice versus a lot. So I put the dress back. I may still consider going back and getting it, but that cute little yellow top. Oh my gosh, it reminded me of childhood and the pretty sweaters and all that stuff. So goodness, lots of talking. So I paired it with a magenta. Oh my goodness, where is this? Where are the sparkles? Here is this magenta scarf yesterday, and it's the Stellar from Rapunzel, and that's why I called it the Stellar Side Bow. Now, when I did this, I had a really hard time with wrapping yesterday morning. I don't know what was going on. My arms were so tired, and I was not. The scarf was not cooperating. It took me, oh my God, 45 minutes. It took me a really long time to get wrapped yesterday. I was getting frustrated with it. Oh my goodness. Now, I did not wear my Wendy yesterday, so I don't think it's going to matter much. I wore the Ultimate, but I don't feel like changing because two out of the three wraps that I wanted to wrap for you are with the Wendy, so I think this will totally do it. And my Wendy is kind of feeling floppy today. So we'll see. Now, what I did is I tied this on almost even, and I always tie things on at an angle because my face shape angles work really well. Almost even. I want to have when I bring the scarf around, I want to have this be slightly shorter. And this one be the tail that comes over this side be slightly longer because I'm going to be bringing this up and I want to make the bow. So I'm going to need the one that has to go around my head from the left side to the right side be slightly longer. You can see. Well, maybe this side, this side. All right. Now, if I did it correctly, that would be amazing. I'm going to do crisscross. This one goes over, the crisscross is over the top. This one goes on the bottom. Not only will it lock, does that lock it in place, it will make for an easy, smooth transition for this being up over the top. Now I'm folding this, making sure that all of the sparkles are on the outside. I'm bringing this up and back and over. Now, when we tie the knot, you can see now that these two are going to be about even. This is a one knot. Okay, bringing this. Do I want to do it that way? We can do it two way, one of two ways. Bring this one up. Can make sure it's neat. Oh my goodness, I'm gonna roll my eyes at myself. All right, I can bring this one around and pull through this way to start the bow in the back, or I can bring it around this way to the front and pull through the front. And do it this way. You can see. Okay. Now, what feels most comfortable for me is normally pulling it. Leave this one here a second. Is pulling it towards the back, Marrakeshi style. Want to make sure I pull it up. Make it sparkles. Okay. So we're going to do it that way. Pulling it up, going around, and then I'm going to pull through for a nice big frill back here. Now you see, this part took me forever yesterday. Oh my gosh, nothing wanted to cooperate yesterday. So, okay, you get this nice big frilly bow in the back. I like to pull it all the way out so I get more frills. And I'm just sticking my thumb in and trying to find the edge. It's pretty wide, so it takes a couple seconds to figure to find the edge of the scarf. Right now it wants me to think that it's an infinity scarf. Oh my goodness. Okay. All right, reaching in. We are going to find that edge. And there it is. Okay. We're pulling this out, making sure it's nice and floofy. And again, this one is coming out so much better today than it did yesterday. I'm taking this piece that's not being utilized, this little teeny tiny piece, and I'm going to take it and run it up underneath, just like so. And because it's a t-shirt scarf, that hides away really well. And for the front, I've got this nice big piece here. I'm going to fan it out. It does help to fan it out first. Okay, and then I'm just going to roll up like so. And my thumbs are down under here and it's hard to see, but I'm just tucking that up underneath. You can see. This guy fell. So I'm just going to roll him under and tuck him, tuck and tuck back here. Tuck it wherever it can tuck. There's one weird spot back here. Okay. All right. And then I have this, I'm just spreading out. Super fun, super frilly, super cute. Now the bow I think is slightly higher than it was yesterday. It can be here, it can be, you know, here, be higher, you can put it up even higher than this. Just adjust your scarf tails accordingly to make sure that when you're getting both ends and tying the knot, that both of them, both tails are equal. That's the key to getting a really pretty floofy equal bow. So this was yesterday's wrap. It's deceptively simple. I mean, it's really easy. It just looks super duper duper hard. Okay, now that's this one. Okay, popping it off. Okay, I'm gonna take a quick drink. Oh my goodness. This is only my second cup of coffee in December. And I think the first one doesn't count because it was an Irish coffee. I took December off from coffee. So I needed a caffeine detox, but, oh my gosh, that tastes so good. All right. Now for the scarf of the month, the style that I did with the rosette on this side, it's the square. So what I did and what I do most of the time with my square scarves is I fold it like so. I'm going to try and find the end with the tag to do that with. Okay, here's the tag. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to fold it like so. Okay. And you can, here's the triangle. I'm going to place it on my head. You can see that. I'm going to place it on my head at the angle. Now, I don't want to have this be too long And I don't want it to be really, really, really super duper short either. It's just long enough so that when it wraps around, I can tuck it into the bottom of my shaper. I don't normally tuck anything back there, but when it's these and it's just this little itty bitty teeny tiny corner, it doesn't cause any pressure points. It doesn't affect the security of my shaper. I just go for it. Okay, so I'm placing it here. I'm bringing this around, being sure to pull it taut, not too tightly. I don't want to damage the scarf, and I don't want to squeeze my head. I'm bringing all of this around. Okay, now, okay, my daughter ran to the store for me to get chivies and just a few things, and she's, give me 1 second, I apologize. Okay. All right, so I have that nicely folded over. What I'm doing now is I'm going to bring this up just like so at an angle. I folded over that bit to hide that tag. I don't want to see that tag. It was really hard during the video once I got to the end point to hide the tag. So I thought about it this time and I'm hiding the tag here. Okay, so I'm bringing this up and I'm bringing it to right here. Don't worry, there are no pins in this portion of the wrap. And I'm going to bring, I'm just grabbing here and I'm just, I guess, pleating it. So I'm bringing it up and I'm covering this slightly, that little piece. You can see that's where I had it. I'm covering it slightly. I'm doing the same thing, just pulling slightly to get it taut. You can see it gets some more pleats. You can fling this behind you, and if that's easier to work with, just grab the edge. And yes, this is a finicky one, and we're pulling. Hard to see, sorry. And the same thing, we are pulling. And if I lose it, like I just did, just grab it and do it again. And there we go, just like so. Get all of this up to here, okay. All right. Just keep working around till you get to the pointy part. There we go. Now, okay, so just pulling it around just like this. And this will pleat all on its own and so pretty. I mean, it will pleat really well. Okay, so when I got to this point, I kind of didn't know what to do. I'm just adjusting just a little bit. I'm giving it a good tug. It's not tightening it too much around my head. It's just making it feel better, more secure on my head. Okay. All right. Now, when I got to this point, I took two pins, try to find them, one down from the back and one down from the front. Don't worry, I will do this one again because I can see already see that this one is going to be a bit of a hard one to show. Okay, so I just have this. Now, what I did is I gave this a twist to give myself a nice rosette right here. and played with it until I got the rosette I wanted. So let me do this one all over again, just start from the beginning so that I can do it and hopefully show it much nicer. And I'm going to trade this one out for a different pin. All right, unfortunately it's gonna have a yellow tip. The edge, the metal part of the pin, this part was a little rough on that one, and I do not want to damage the scarf. This scarf is too much awesomeness. Okay, so I'm gonna recheck my folding. I'm going to place it on my head, just like so. Also, for the lovely ladies that noticed on the edge of this scarf, that is like a mauve-y color. It is absolutely the blues. I talked about all the colors in the video, the blues and the golds and the silvers. There's a bit of a mauve-y, and depending on how it hits the light, it comes up either mauve or a dusty pink. So it's really interesting. Okay, so placing it on my head. I'm gonna move the shaver back just a little bit. All right, put it on my head like so. Oh, okay, bringing it around. I'm tucking it back into the back of the shaper. I'm going to come down. Goodness. Okay. Coming down, pulling it a little bit, bringing all of this over to the side. Now, observation that I'm having right now, the Cloud 9 would be amazing with this. And this came up a little bit, but that's okay. This, I think the Cloud 9 would work really well with this wrap. All right. Now I'm taking this front portion that's already nicely folded over for me. I'm bringing it up and back just like so. And I'm grabbing the edge just this much back. I'm folding it over like so, doing the same thing to cover my face. This is why it all ended up behind me before. Okay, I'm just grabbing and pulling over. Okay. All right, there we go. That's better. I'm just pulling it and pulling it. Okay. And I just wrangled this back so that it came in neatly. And I'm just going to hold this here really quickly. I'm going to put this around. I don't remember it giving me this much trouble the first time I did it. But it's probably me, not the scarf, because the scarf is really, really being easy to work with. I personally think I'm doing something weird. So I think it's because I'm actually having to talk and do at the same time. It's easier to just do. So it's my inability to talk and do at the same time. That's killing me on this one. Okay. Have that all neat, so I have this nice big cascade. We're gonna try again and stick in this guy here. Careful not to stab yourself in the head, but to catch all of the layers. Okay, and then one more in the front that will just it'll just catch everything and keep it. Okay. All right. Now that that's done, I can give this a little bit of a talk, a little bit of poke, shape that a bit. Adjust some pleats a little bit. I wouldn't fuss too much with it because it could damage the scarf by popping out pins, and that would be no good. All right, now that we have it this far, I'm gonna make sure I have all my pins. I think it's a total of six pins. Okay, have them here. Now I can do it this way to get a nice swirl. This is rather lovely. I don't want to do twisting too tautly, because then you lose the effect of the rosette. So I've got two pins in already. I'm taking one pin underneath. You can see here, I hope, underneath, just to pin it in the back. So I want one on the bottom, so I can take it underneath like so, and then I want one in the top front. That three space, or the three pins, triangle pins. Oh my goodness. The pins set like a triangle will really hold that in place without having to stab 1,000 holes into your scarf. Now, I really like the way this turned out with this one piece here. But if you didn't like that, you could just tuck it in and make sure to grab it with your pin when you're pinning it. Where did my pin go? There you are. Okay. So if you didn't like it, you could just grab this, sticking it through the edge and pulling it right back out. Sticking it through the edge, lifting this up and stabbing it up in there, just like so. So this came out really well. What I did for my photograph, because I wanted to add a little center, is, ow, that hurt, my goodness. Is I put a brooch right in the center, and this is the brooch that I used. I'm not gonna pin it in because I don't want to, sorry. But totally add a brooch right here or not. I honestly wish I wouldn't have put a brooch on it because it's pretty just the way it is, like so. Now, if you didn't want it so big, or you saw that you have, just to do it an alternate way, you could do the spinning this way, where you split it and you have the center like so. Sometimes while I'm doing these wraps, and I know this is weird, but sometimes when I'm doing these wraps on the videos, I'm looking at it and I go back and go, you know, I really could have done it this way. So I automatically change, but give you both of these. And I can't remember which way I did it in the video, but this one is also a way that you can do the rosette. Give this a twist it outward, and then bring it up and bring this around. This way you only need two pins. You don't need to do the three. One on the inside and then one right there. And you've got a rosette as well. And then again, if you wanted to place your pin in there, of course, use this the brooch back and make sure it stays in there. But that's how I did the wrap. I'm hoping this was more clear than in my Scarf of the Month video. Sometimes with those, I get too excited and just start wrapping and my words don't always come out. Okay, so I'm gonna take this one off. Where are you? Don't damage. Okay, find the head. Oh my goodness. All right. There you are. Okay. All right, now I'm gonna take out these here. And then we'll talk about the scarves I just got. This was a picture. I took a picture of it. This is what I'm going to be wearing tonight because I'm wearing green. I'm going to wear green. I'm going to have, I have a turtleneck. Very, very, very comfortable turtleneck, long dress. It's figure hugging, but not, I don't know how to, other way to put it. It doesn't go cinch me in, but it just skims my curves. Let's see. So I'm going to be wearing that nice turtleneck. So just got this in from Rapunzel. I ordered this. I think I made a post about it. It was my perfect pairing that I thought was like, oh my gosh, I must get this. It was in this Poignant Musings scarf in dark green. They had it on the site. I believe it's sold out now. But they had it on the site, they meaning Rapunzel, in two colors. There was a gray and there was a green. I'm gonna put this aside. So it was super pretty. I needed no more gray scarves, and I thought that this one was so much prettier. Oh my gosh, with the green. I thought that this would really go good with my complexion and my eye color. Maybe it would make my eyes pop a little blue instead of going all gray. The crazy thing about blue eyes, they can change so dramatically with what color you put on. Now, the second scarf, you know, I saw this one and I went, you know what would be the absolute perfect scarf to go with this? The light pink 2-in-1. I know it's like completely opposite. It's so cool. It's so pretty, but it's the light pink. Get it closer, maybe to get a better idea of the color. But I really like this combination of the pastel pink and the, let me turn this off now. My daughter contacted me, so I don't have to keep that. I like the idea of this light pink with the green. I thought it was really pretty. Oh my goodness. And then I said, oh, but wait. I need to have options. So I said, well, what other scarf can I put with it that would be really, really pretty? And this was on my wish list for a long time. This is the Mulberry Shimmery. It's been on my wish list for, I'm going to say years. And I haven't ordered it because there's always something that I need more than this one. So I thought, oh my gosh, this is the perfect set. Because I've got the Mulberry and I've got this pink that would go good together, and then I've got the green. So I'm thinking that these guys would make the most amazing sets. Yeah, I can wear any two or I can wear all three of them. So this is my idea. I'm not thinking that I'm going to wear all three of them this evening. I'm thinking I'm going to be wearing the green one. And I don't know if I want shiny or shimmeries with it. I think it looks gorgeous. I'm just not thinking that's the vibe I'm going for this evening. So what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to wear this green with the light pink. I think that'll be a good combination to ring in the new year. Not too aggressive, not overly saturated, not too much. But green being a good color, new beginnings, and so that's what I'm thinking. So that's what I'm going to go with. I'm not going to be wrapping right this minute. I'll probably wrap around 4 or 5 for what I'm wearing tonight. Sorry, that one's going to be a surprise. I'll film while I'm doing it and I'll post it tomorrow. But I do know. I'm going to be using this pin. I was going to say, I don't know if I'm going to wear a pin, but I am going to be wearing a pin. I'm going to be wearing this one. This one is the Fleurs and Frills pin. I'm looking at my notes. I wrote them down so I don't tell you the wrong thing. This one is available on the Rapunzel site. I'm going to be placing it with this because I thought this was amazing with the flowers. I thought that would be perfect. So that's what I'm going to be wearing, this pin with the green and the pink and the pretty dress. Okay, now to take a break from talking about the scarves, and I'm going to scratch my face, and my face is itchy today. It's like right here, I'm itchy. I got some really great deals at the Ulta last week. And sounds like my daughter's home. The first deal is this Kat Von D lipstick. It's a liquid lipstick. It was $5. I was like, okay, that's cool. It is a beautiful shade, light pink. The color, if I can get my eyeballs to work. Holy crow. Requiem. Awesome. That's a great name for a lipstick, Requiem. It's a character in one of the books I'm reading. I should say rereading. I think I've read the series 26 times. I'm one of those. And at this point, I'm actually hate reading the series because books 15 through to the end, I'm invested already in the series. So, oh my goodness, but that's what that's called, Requiem. It's really fun. I'm going to see if I swatch it a little bit. I don't know anything about Kat Von D or KVD lipsticks. I don't really buy the products, but I just couldn't, at $5 when it was originally $21, I couldn't pass that up. So, it's one of my favorite shades of the pink. It's like a dusty color. It's not super vibrantly pink. So, but I don't know as far as staying power, how that goes. So, and of course, I do not have something to wipe it off with. I'll just use a sponge. Okay. All right, wipe that off with a sponge. All right, now, the next thing I have is this other lipstick. This one is, oh my goodness, it's L'Oreal and it's Lilac Impulse. It's color number 975. Now this one I picked up because this is the color. I'm always looking, oh my goodness, for the color that I got married. When I got married, this is the color lipstick I wore. But it was a benefit and this is it. It was so pretty. It's nude, but when it hits a certain light, it's got a purple shimmer to it. And Benefit no longer makes, I don't even have to, it's so old. It's 21 years old. Crazy, right? It's 21 years old. And no, don't worry, I don't use it. I keep it because I want the color. I really want this color. And I can't find it. Nobody makes this color anymore. So I keep it in hopes that I will swatch one day. And the color that I swatch with it will match or come close. So I'll put that back in the drawer. But I saw this one and I went, that's really close. I wonder if, and not quite. It's missing the shimmer and it's, while it sort of goes there, it's not the same, but you know what? I'll wear it. But that's why I picked this one up. This one, it also was on sale. It was really inexpensive, like $4 or something. But I thought that I would take a chance to get This is the one that I really want. Oh my goodness. So I have to find one of those companies that like perfumes, like discontinued perfumes. There are companies that make the formulas for discontinued perfumes. Just wondering if there are companies that make discontinued lipstick colors. One can only hope. I'm giving the Anastasia Beverly Hills eye primer a shot. I'm out of my Morphe one, and I want to know if this one actually works better than that one. This one got decent reviews. Most people liked it. I think the people that didn't like it put on too much, and it was hard for them to rub in. I was reading all the reviews on these things. So I don't know. We'll see. Let me try that. I will see if I like it. Also, before I get to the one that I was like, oh my. I'm trying out new deodorant. I know that's weird to talk about, but I'm gonna do it anyway. I'm trying to avoid all the chemical and the one I can't even say like the secret. I'm trying to get away from Secret and Dove and all those with all the aluminums and stuff. So I'm trying out natural brands. And this one was funny because it's Meow Meow Tweet. That's the name of the brand. And it's like a cream. And you just take a little teeny tiny, it says a pea-sized portion, and rub it on like lotion. I made it through the entire day yesterday with no issues, no sweating, no odor. So I'm going to put this to the test when I'm exercising because I need to actually do that. I'm getting that set up downstairs in the call it a family room, call it the man cave. I'm getting the gym reset up down there. Now I call it a gym, and it's loosely a gym. I have three pieces of equipment that are useful. I just ordered a weighted hula hoop because who doesn't like the hula hoop? That's going to be so much fun. And I think that's the thing that holds me back from exercising more than I do is it's not fun. I want to do things that are fun. And I no longer have a VHS player. Some of you may know what that is. Some of you may not. But I have all of the Tybo tapes, cassette tapes or VHS tapes, and I have no way to play them. And that was fun. That was fun. I don't. I Richard Simmons was a thing from my youth, and he was fun at the time. It's not my thing. I'm not going there. But I think I even have one of his VHSs in there somewhere. Got Belly Dance, but I no longer have a DVD player because everything is digital. I don't need, so I don't have a DVD player. So I can't belly dance. And I'm not making a special subscription to all those things for that. So I'm hoping with the addition of the hula hoop and making an actual gym downstairs so I don't have to go out and maybe be exposed to the corona. I know they're doing a really good job cleaning, but I don't want to put myself in that situation with being out at a gym. And I don't want to put the workers at the gym in that kind of position. So I'm just going to put the gym together downstairs and see. I also replaced the big exercise ball because we got Micah. I had a big pink one and it was kind of fun. I was sitting on it while I was embroidering the chuppah and little man jumped when he was itty bitty. He jumped up on it and like this into the ball and that's sad, but it happens. So I'm hoping that I can keep him from doing this on the new one and do exercising with the exercise ball. So, okay. Now the final thing, and I know I've talked a lot about weird stuff, but this is where my brain is going and I want to get everything into the video. The final thing that I was not going to buy, was so not going to buy, it was on the it's really pretty, but I don't need it list. Until I saw Leora's video, and then I was like, oh gosh, I've got to have it now. And I did get it on sale. Is Juvia's Place Valhalla 2 palette. Once I saw it in action, I was like, yeah. But I had a big coupon and I got it on sale, so it became part of my collection. But they're just so pretty. They're just so pretty. I was missing, in all the palettes that I have down there, I was missing these. These. All these blues. And the greens. Then I don't have a lot of that in the Juvia's Place palettes that I have. These are really fun. And you know, this purple's kind of cool here. I don't want to rub myself all with makeup today. So, but I was so not going to buy this, but it was too pretty to pass up. I'm going to probably have to, because I'm a completionist, I will probably go and look for the original Valhalla palette. I'm thinking, probably after the first of the year, Juvia's Place will probably restock things and we'll see if it comes back. If it doesn't, then I won't cry, but the completionist in me is like, yeah, you should buy it just to have the first one and the second one. But that's that. Now, I am going to finish this video off by doing a quick wrap so that I have something on my head besides a shaper. Oh my goodness. Ah, reaching down. I'm just putting on my Israeli. This one is a gray one with the silver shimmers instead of the gold shimmers. So, oh my goodness, I'm going to fold it over the same way I've been doing it. I'm just going to do a quick regal style. Okay. Folding, tucking under, not ripping out my hair. Okay. All right. Just like so. Okay. Making sure this is all folded in neatly. Okay. And then I'm going to bring it up at the angle, and you can see I have some tucking to do back here and tucking up here. I try to make this so that as I'm pulling this around to tuck in, I tuck in all the short parts. Sometimes this works and sometimes I have to go back after I tuck the long piece in. And finesse it. Like right here, I've got one short piece that wants to come out, followed by a second. And then I have this piece here that wants to come out, and I just tuck it in. But this will get me through all my chores for the day, and then I'll wrap later. Just like so. And save my nice gray eyes. That's insane, right? Okay, so I hope everyone has a happy new year. Be safe, and I will see you in the next tutorial.